and my parents transferred me to a small private school. And Valley Christian School didn't offer football, and they didn't offer a lot of other things that I wanted to take, like French class and shop class. So I was pretty bitter about being made to go there, and I decided I didn't want to be there. So I rejected all the sports, the few sports that they did offer. And instead, I looked forward to getting back to the 20 acres and playing with my brothers and sisters. And my brothers and I would make up all kinds of games to entertain ourselves. One of them involved throwing tennis balls at each other from close range as hard as we could. Another trampoline game was called Bruise, and I don't have time to go into all the rules, but the name says a lot. And I was—I always liked to fly or fall through the air off bridges or off my chimney onto a pile of mattresses. And so when I discovered aerials, it was love at first sight. And it took me a few years to earn enough money to get to a training facility. But finally, shortly before my 19th birthday, I made it out to Lake Placid, New York, and I had $10 to spare. I planned on camping in my tent when I got there, but the national team had a free house and room for me, so they let me stay there. And one night there was a big party downstairs, and that was a surprise to me that athletes even partied. So I was a pretty sheltered kid. I wasn't a typical 19-year-old. I was pretty innocent. I didn't listen to rock music. I didn't drink. I didn't believe in sex before marriage. I had never been to a prom. And so I was surprised the next day to see that one of the athletes had ridden an easy chair down the stairs and through a window. And I think it was at that moment that I decided I could make the team. Obviously, I grew up a lot those first few years in Lake Placid, but the work ethic I learned in back to Montana, feeding horses, chopping wood, moving irrigation pipes, and repairing fences, that stuck with me. And I used that to train harder than anybody else. In fact, I didn't think that training was hard work at all. So I took a lot of jumps. I loved to jump, and it only took me 10 years to make it to the top of the Olympic podium. And I would like to thank the U.S. Ski and Snowboard Association for helping to make that possible. And I'd also like to thank my wife, Sally Jo, for patiently waiting 6 years for me to get my fill of the sport before we can move back home to Montana and start our new life. And we're not exactly sure what that new life is going to be, but we are expecting our first child next fall, so we're excited for that adventure. And although I never got a college education, I did earn my PhD because I was poor, hungry, and driven. So I'm prepared for whatever life has to offer next. Thanks a lot.